Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Learn Russian with Irina, and this is the first lesson dedicated to Russian verbs that we use in daily life. I should mention that this topic is kind of difficult as each verb in Russian changes its ending many times. It depends on what pronoun is used in a sentence, on what tense we're using, and there are three tenses: present, past, and future, and three moods as well: indicative, subjunctive, and imperative. And the most important thing is that we have two verb conjunctions, the first type and the second type. Of course, there is a structure that you can master and know in which case one or another verb ending should be used. However, you are going to face with some verb exceptions as well, and the only way to start using them is to learn them by heart. But if you do a lot of practice, I'm sure you'll succeed. Let's begin studying today's verb, that is to ask, спрашивать or просить.
Спрашивать, просить.
Let's look at the endings that this verb may have in present tense.
Я спрашиваю, я прошу. Ты спрашиваешь, ты просишь. Вы спрашиваете, вы просите. Мы спрашиваем, мы просим. Он, она, оно спрашивает. Он, она, оно просит. Они спрашивают, они просят.
I'm gonna show you some sentences with this verb in different forms.
Он просит ему помочь. Он просит ему помочь. Они просят поднять им зарплату. Они просят поднять им зарплату. Вы спрашиваете, зачем это мне? Вы спрашиваете, зачем это мне?
Normally, the verb спрашивать in present tense is not used so often. And when it's used, it usually has a very strong meaning, and the person who is pronouncing this verb is supposed to be in a bad mood. For example, when your boss is not happy with the work that you are doing, he can ask you the following. I'm asking you, why the report is not ready yet? Я спрашиваю тебя, почему доклад до сих пор не готов?
Я спрашиваю, почему доклад до сих пор не готов? Я спрашиваю, почему доклад до сих пор не готов?
The verb просить in present tense sounds good and it doesn't have a negative tone. Now let's look at these two words in past tense.
Я спрашивал, спрашивала. Я просил, просила. Ты спрашивал, спрашивала. Ты просил, спросил. Просила. Вы спрашивали, вы просили, спросили. Мы спрашивали, мы просили. Он спрашивал, он просил. Она спрашивала, она просила, спросила. Оно спрашивало, оно просило, спросило. Они спрашивали, они просили, спросили.
Now you're wondering, what is the difference between просил and спросил? Actually, it's very similar to English meaning of perfect tense and imperfect. In Russian, we have perfect verbs as well as imperfect. So if somebody was doing something in the past for a very long period of time, we should use the verb in its imperfect form. For example, I was asking you 10 times to do that. Я просила тебя 10 раз сделать это.
Я просила тебя 10 раз сделать это. Я просила тебя 10 раз сделать это.
A verb in perfect form we could use in the next sentence. Они спросили нас, где находится супермаркет. They asked us where the supermarket was located.
Они спросили нас, где находится супермаркет. Они спросили нас, где находится супермаркет.
And here we can see that they asked this information only once. In the previous sentence, a girl was asking somebody for something 10 times. And that is the difference between the words спрашивать and просить. Finally, let's look at the verb endings in future tense.
Я спрошу, я попрошу. Ты спросишь, ты попросишь. Вы спросите, вы попросите. Мы спросим, мы попросим. Он, она, оно спросит, он, она, оно попросит. Они спросят, они попросят.
In future tense, both verbs have a regular meaning. Neither of them is strong, so you shouldn't be so careful when you use them. And here I also have two sentences for you. The first one is Я спрошу его адрес. I'll ask his address.
Я спрошу его адрес. Я спрошу его адрес.
The next one is Она попросит его прийти на вечеринку. She'll ask him to go over to her party.
Она попросит его прийти на вечеринку. Она попросит его прийти на вечеринку.
Please note that there is no difference between masculine and feminine genders in present and future tenses. In past tense, you can see both genders, and the good news is that many endings are repeated. I think now you have enough material to study, even though we learned only two verbs. But as you can see, there were a lot of different endings. Actually, there are more of them, and I'm sure we'll study them in the future. In the meantime, please keep practicing, ask me any questions that you have, and subscribe to my channel. Take care, and see you soon. До свидания!